Hi friend. So note down question number 22. A single phase transformer has a turns ratio of 1 to 1 by 2 and is connected to a purely resistive load as shown in the figure. The magnetizing current drawn is 1 ampere and the secondary current is 1 ampere. If core losses and leakage reactances are neglected, then find out the primary current. So what is the figure that is given in the question? You note it down. Current is, sorry, this is not 1 ohm, 1 ampere is given. Okay. Secondary current, 1 ampere that is given, and also magnetizing current I mu that is given 1 ampere. And also given the condition that leakage reactance and core losses are neglected. Leakage reactance. And core losses are neglected. So what would be the phasor diagram for this particular type of transformer? The phasor diagram would be, this is the flux that is to be taken as reference. Flux produce flux flowing is the core of transformer, right? It is I mu is in phase of flux. Is it clear? That is magnetizing current, which always is in phase of flux. Okay? And this is a terminal voltage V1. Okay? As we have stated in the transformer that flux flows in the core of the transformer is lagging by 90 degree from supplied voltage. Is it clear? Right? And the EMF produced to the both the winding E1 and E2 would be in equal, this E1 would be equal to the B1, but in opposite direction. Is it clear? V1, this is E1, would be equal, but in opposite direction. Why? Because of Lenz principle. Okay? And since E2 produces in the secondary winding, produced by same flux, that's why E2 also is in same phase of E1, but not equal. It can be higher, it can be lower, but it can be equal in what case? When both has unit turn ratio. Is it clear? Now, this is the load, resistive load. So, the current I2 would be in phase of and there will be a magnetizing branch between source. This is not given in the question, but in the question it is being said that core losses are neglected. What is the meaning of that? IC is neglected, and RC flowing in which branch? This is the exact equivalent circuit, right? Exact magnetizing branch. Is it clear? This resistance corresponds to core losses is in the transformer. In the question it is mentioned that core losses are neglected. So what we will do? We will make it zero. Whatever current is flowing is in the magnetizing branch, that is I mu, that is in magnetizing inductance, I mu would be equal to I naught. Is it clear? This would be I naught. And here the I2 dash, and what is the significance of I2 dash? it is counterbalancing current. When load changes to make the constant flux is in the transformer, I2 dash flows is in the primary side, is in the primary side to balance this one. That's why it is known as counterbalancing current. Okay? And this is primary current I1. Is it clear? So I1 is phasor sum of I2 dash and phasor sum of I2 dash and I0. Is it clear or not? So I2 dash phasor sum of I2 dash and I0. And how we can find out the I2 dash? I2 dash is nothing but I2 by A. If A is given 1 by A is, that is turns ratio is 1 by 2. Is it clear? So this value becomes 1 ampere by 1 by 2 would be 2 ampere. Is it clear? And I mu is given, that is 1 ampere in the question. So what is the phasor sum? Phasor sum is I naught. What I am saying, that is primary current I1. We need to find out the primary current, that is I1, primary current. Is it clear? So I1 would be how much? Root 1 square, 2 square, that is root 5. Root 5 is 2.24 ampere. So which option is correct? Option C is correct. This question asked in GATE 2010. Is it clear? Now note down question number 23. Question number 23. It is desired to measure a parameter of 230. A single phase AA co-transformer fed from a rated sinusoidal supplier is operating at no load. The steady state magnetizing current drawn by transformer from the supply will have the waveform. The four options are given in terms of waveform, right? So we need to find out which option is correct. So that I will give you is in the PDF form. So what is given? That is air core. Transformer. So what do you understand by air core transformer? So what do you understand by air core transformer? That this is one winding and this is another blind winding, and between those winding air is filled. There is no magnetic material. There is no core material, right? That's why it is known as air core transformer. Voltage induces in both the winding. Voltage induced in the secondary winding by induction through air, not by magnetic core, not by ferromagnetic core. Is it clear? That's why it is known as air core transformer. So what is the, so do we get any saturation in that kind of transformer? I want to ask a question. Do we get any kind of saturation in that kind of transformer? We do not get any kind of saturation because medium is air, right? So VH curve, that in case of ferromagnetic material, if the core is made of ferromagnetic material, then what happens? That we have seen the VH curve is look like this is the BH curve correspond to ferromagnetic material type of core. Is it clear? But if we have air core transformer, then BH curve would be linear. That is linear. In that case, we do not get any saturation. If we do not get any saturation, it means we do not get any peaky kind of waveform is current drawn from the supply. That we have studied in the last lecture of transformer. When we have this kind of VH curve, then we got peaky magnetizing wave, peaky current to get the sinusoidal flux. If we want to get the sinusoidal flux for the air core transformer, we would have completely sinusoidal current that is to be taken from the supply. Is it clear so? I hope you understood. That's why option C is correct. We will have current drawn from the supply would be sinusoidal, not peaky. So I would like to question you, if we have ferromagnetic material, then what kind of current we will draw? We will draw peaky magnetizing, peaky wave, which will contain third harmonic. Is it clear? So option C is correct. This is asked in GATE 2011. Question number 24. A single phase transformer has no load loss of 64 watt as obtained from an open circuit test. When a short circuit test is performed on it with 90% of the rated current flowing in its both LV and HV windings, the measured loss is 81 watt. The transformer has maximum efficiency when operated at. So I hope you understood the question, or shall I repeat again? Question number 24. A single phase, no load loss, that is given 84 watt. So what is no load loss? No load loss is nothing but core loss, that is constant throughout. It does not change when load change. That's why it is known as constant loss, or we can say no load loss. During no load, that is open circuit test, what we do? We completely open that circuit. So in that respect, no load current flows. If no load current is 2 to 3%, then what happens? Copper loss would be very, very less. That's why we got only core loss during no load test. That's why no load loss are equal to core loss. So core loss is how much? 64 watt. As obtained from an open circuit test, right? When a short circuit test is performed on it, when with 90% of rated current flowing in its both LV and HV windings, the measured loss is 81 watt. So 81 watt we got, that is copper loss at 90% of rated current. So what will be the full load copper loss? Full load copper loss means 100% rated current. What would be? So full load, that is full load, or we can say at 100% of rated current would be how much? It would be 81 divided by 0.81, or we can say 0.9 square. Is it clear? So 81.81 equals to 100 watt. This will be the full load copper loss. Is it clear? The transformer has maximum efficiency when operated at. The transformer has maximum efficiency when operated at. And for maximum efficiency, what is the condition? Copper loss should be equals to core loss. Is it clear or not? Copper loss should be equals to core loss. This is the condition of maximum efficiency. Is it clear? So at what load? At what load it would be equal to? Then we multiply x square. That is the x factor that tell us about at which power, at which load it is maximum efficiency. So x square is nothing but p core, that is constant, does not change, p copper, that is full load. X copper is full load. At full load, and p core, how much we got? 64 divided by 100, that is x, how much? 8 by 10, that is 0.8, that is 80% of rated current. Option C is correct. 80% of rated current we would get the maximum efficiency. Is it clear so? Question number 25. This question asked in GATE 2013. This question number 24. Note down question number 25. Assuming an ideal transformer, Thevenin's equivalence voltage and impedance as seen from the terminals X and Y for the circuit in figure R. So given circuit is this is the terminal X and Y, and we need to find out the Thevenin equivalent circuit as seen from terminal X and Y. Is it clear? So the voltage given, that is sine omega t. So as you have done the course of circuit theory, so how we find out the Thevenin equivalent circuit? How we find out? We've seen the voltage at which it is to be find out. From this side, it is to be find out. So find out the voltage that is induced in the secondary winding. So how much induced? That is, and the turns ratio given 1, 2. So it would be nothing but 2 sine omega t. So what is Vxi? Vxi would be 2 sine omega t. Is it clear or not? 2 sine omega t. And what is the impedance? What is the impedance that would be seen from the terminal X and Y? Do you get my question? So what we do to find out the equivalent circuit? We make the source short circuit. We make the source short circuit, or we make all the active source short circuit to find out the Thevenin equivalent circuit, as we have done the course of circuit theory. Is it clear? So what we do? Make it short circuit. Okay. Then this 1 ohm resistance would be referred to this side. So how much it would be? It would be 1 multiply 2 square. Is it clear or not? So it would be 2 ohm. 2 ohm. So option which is satisfied? Sorry, this is 4 ohm, not 4. 2 square is 4 ohm. So option 1 is correct. That is 2 sin omega t would be the voltage across V, across XY, and the impedance that would be here, that would be 4 ohm. Is it clear? Question number 30. Question number 30, a single phase 50 kVA, 1000 volt by 100 volt, two winding transformer is connected as an auto transformer as shown in figure. The kVA rating of auto transformer is how much? We need to calculate. So this is asked in GATE 2014. This is given 1000 volt and this is how much? 1100 volt. Is it clear? And here is dot is available as per the given question. So this is 100 volt. So this would be how much? This would be 100 volt. Is it clear? 100 volt. So the rating of this is a two winding transformer. This is a two winding transformer as per the question, that is 1000 volt and this is 100 volt. Is it clear? Is it clear or not? Right? And the kVA rating of transformer, 220 transformer is 50 kVA. So can you please tell me what will be the current flowing in each winding? Find out, this is the I1 and this is I2. So I1 would have 50 kVA by 1000. That will be 50 ampere. 50 ampere would flow in this direction. Is it clear? And I2, that would be 50k divided by 1000, sorry 100, it would be 500 ampere. It would be 500 ampere. That would be 500 ampere. So what you see, the current direction, suppose this is the A terminal, and this is C and D. Is it clear? So this would be A, this is B, and this would be C, and this is D. A and D would be common point. So current flows D to C, that is 500 ampere. And from A to B, that is 50 ampere. Is it clear? 50 ampere. Is it clear or not? So what is the current in this branch? It would be 550 ampere. Is it clear or not? So what is the kVA rating of auto transformer? That is S auto is 1000 multiply 555 volt. That is 50,5550 kVA. Is it clear? Or we can recheck that value we find out from the primary side. Now we can find out from the secondary side. See, this would be same SO2 and secondary 11 multiply 500. That will be 550 kVA. Now you can see both the values are coming same. It means whatever we do, that is correct, right? So which option is correct? There is no option available, that is the numerical type of questions that is generally, that is basically introduced in the earlier it is being introduced in the GATE exam. Okay. This question asked in GATE 2014 that we have put down. Now find question number 31. Sorry, the question number 27. This is not 30, this question number 26. Is it clear? 26. Now question number 27. Question number 27. A single phase, a 220 by 440 volt 50 hertz single phase transformer operates on 220 volt 40 hertz supply with secondary winding, then of four options are given. One option, I am reading the question options. The eddy current loss and hysteresis loss of the transformer decreases. So before I read the options, let me do the question first. So this is the hertz transformer. This is the operating condition first. Now what we do, we operate the transformer at 220 volt. It doesn't change, it does not change, but the frequency is changed. This is the second operating condition. Now we need to find out which factor would change, which value would be changed when we change the frequency but the voltage is unchanged. Is it clear? So what is eddy current formula? Is Ke Vm square F square, and V is proportional to F Vm. So it would be Ke V square. Is it clear? So what we observe from here? Eddy current loss always dependent on voltage. Always dependent on voltage. If voltage does not change, it means eddy current would not change. So voltage is not changing, it means that is constant. Is it clear or not? And what is hysteresis loss? KH Vm F. That is Vm square. So KH Vm multiply F, that is V proportional, suppose, and Vm we can also done this V divided by F, so it would be KH V square by F. It is proportional, not equal, right? So VF is PH is proportional of anti-proportional of frequency. Is it clear? This is the case when V by F is not constant. We have done two types of cases in the transformer theory. That is case one, when VI, two case. One is when V by F is constant, and second one is V by F is not constant. When V by F is not constant, it means eddy current is always dependent on supply voltage. If supply voltage does not change, then eddy current would remain, eddy current loss would remain same. But the hysteresis loss would be dependent on frequency. It is anti-proportional of frequency. If frequency decreases, it means hysteresis loss increases. This frequency decreases, it means it is increases. So hysteresis loss increases. So which option satisfied? Option second, read the eddy current loss and is the sorry. Option C is correct. Why? Because the hysteresis loss of the transformer increases because frequency decreases, right? And the eddy current loss remains the same. It does not change. So option C is correct. Is it clear? This question asked in GATE 1993. Question 8. Question 28. A voltage V equals to 400 sine 314160. V is given, that is 400 sine 314160 is applied to single phase transformer on low load. If no load current of transformer is I, that is given 2 sine 314.16 minus 85, that is given in the question, then find out the magnetizing branch impedance will be approximately. This is the magnetizing branch and this voltage across this is given, that is V, and the current flowing I. So what will be the magnetizing impedance? That is Zm. Zm would be V by I. And V by I would be 400. If we write this in phasor, is in polar value. And this will be 2 angle minus 85. This would be 285. Zm. So which option is correct? Option C is correct. This question asked in GATE 1997. Is it clear? Now note down question number 29. Question number 29. A 50 Hz transformer having equal hysteresis and eddy current losses at rated excitation is operated at 45 Hz at 90% of its rated voltage compared to rated operating point. The core losses under this condition would be how much? As per the option. So what is given? You note down. This question asked in GATE 98. When transformer operated at 50 Hz, it has equal hysteresis loss and eddy current loss. Eddy current loss and hysteresis loss equal. PE1 suppose PH1. Is it clear? At rated excitation. When transformer is operated at 45 Hz at rated at 90% of rated voltage. So this is the first condition at 50 Hz. And the second condition at 45% and sorry, this is 45 Hz and 90% rated voltage. Is it clear? So this is the case of, so frequency reduces how much? That is 10%. If you find out the 10% of 50, that is 5 hertz. So 10% frequency reduces and also 10% rated voltage is decreasing. It means VYF remains constant, right? So if VYF remains constant, then what we will see? The eddy current is proportional to square of frequency, and hysteresis loss is proportional to supply frequency. Is it clear? Is it clear or not? That we have done is in the theory of transformer, right? So when VYF is constant, this is the solution, right? VYF is constant. Why? Because 10% of frequency reduces and also 10% voltage reduces. So PE is proportional to F square and hysteresis proportional to F. So this is KH F square and this is KE, sorry, what I am doing, KH F. So what will be PE1? So total core loss is eddy current and hysteresis loss for the first operating condition at 50 hertz and rated voltage. P core 1 at a rated condition, PE1 plus PH1, and both are equal, then is 2PH1. Is it clear? And for second operating condition, P core 2 is PE2 plus PH2, right? So PE1, this is how much? KE how much? F square. It is operating at 45 hertz. So 45 hertz square. Is it clear or not? And this is proportional to frequency. It means it is KH 45. Is it clear or not? And this KE value we can find out. PE1 is KE 50 hertz. So KE is PE1 by 50 hertz. And similarly, KH would be how much? PH1 by 50. I hope you understood. PH1 by 50. Is it clear or not? Right? So put this value, PE1, 45 divided by 50 square, and this is PH1, that is 45 divided by 50. Is it clear or not? PE1 is equals to PH1. PH1, right? And this is 45 square by 50 square. How much we got? How much we got? Find out. That is 1.71. PH1. This is P core 2. Is it clear or not? Right? And this is 2 times of PH1. How much it increase? How much it reduce? It is reduces decrement of how much? That is 2pH1 minus 1.7 pH1 divided by 2pH1. So how much it is? It is 0.29 pH1 by 2pH1. It is 0.145, that is 14.5% coal loss reduces. 14.5% value reduces when we operate the transformer at 45 hertz and 90% of rated voltage. Or we can say both voltage and frequency are reduces by 10%. Reduce by 10%, then how much coal loss we got? Coal loss reduces by 14.5%. So by reducing both voltage and frequency to make constant flux, coal loss reduces by 14.5%. Is it clear?